Good morning. My name is Jeremy Ron. I'm the Public Information Officer for Incident Management Team 2, as well as the Lead Public Information Officer for the LNU Lightning Complex. Just a couple things this morning. If we'd appreciate everybody viewing this or re-sharing this to make sure that we keep our interpreter in all of your shots so we make sure and reach the entire community. I'd like to begin this morning with just a quick statewide summary. Over 14,000 firefighters continue to battle more than two dozen major fires and lightning complexes across California. Since a lightning siege that started on Saturday, August 15th, there have been over 13,000 lightning strikes. Just to kind of give a little perspective, is compared to 2019, California experienced a significant increase of the number of wildfires and acres burned. An astonishing 2,700 more wildfires have occurred this year than last, with an additional 1.4 million acres burned in the same time period. One of the things I wanted to mention briefly this morning was the overwhelming support to the local firefighters, the community, and these complexes have shown. The firefighters are supported within this incident for food and other things that are needed. Please, anybody that would like to support members impacted from these fires, please reach out to agencies such as the Red Cross or local community service clubs or other areas that are able to funnel all of that support out to the fire residents that have been displaced and impacted. The firefighters are well supported through these incidents, and we really appreciate your support. But please, on our behalf, if that support could be generated to the people that have been displaced or have had their homes damaged or destroyed, that would be appreciated. Again, I just wanted to mention for this complex, our 24-hour phone number is 707-967-4207. And now with an operational update, I'd like to bring up Chief Chris Waters. Chief.
Good morning. So for this morning's operational update, I'm going to start out with kind of giving a general overview of the fire area. Fire area is significantly large. We've broken into two zones. We have the west zone out here between the Pacific Ocean and the Sonoma County line. And then we have the east zone, which starts at the Sonoma County line and over to Yolo and Sonoma counties. Starting off with a fire up in the Jenner area, the Myers Fire. Got a pretty good handle on that one, and starting to think about doing some repopulation and opening Highway 1. Over to the Wallbridge Fire, which is situated between Lake Sonoma in the north and Guerneville in the south, making a lot of good progress with bulldozers, hand crews, fire engines. Had a really good day yesterday and hoping for a better day today. Pretty much connecting the dots between vineyards, grassy areas, areas that have good topography, and trying to connect the dots to try and contain this and keep it from moving any further in the direction of the Russian River. Starting on the south end of the east zone, working from Highway 80 up to about Atlas Peak, fire's looking real good and started repopulation operations. From Atlas Peak, moving up behind Polk Valley up to the Palisades, which are behind the community of Calistoga. Starting to feel a little better about that containment, quite a bit of dozer line, mostly dozer line. And we're currently at the highest priority of the fire right now, which is in the Palisades, working our way up towards the Lake County line. In that area, there's a bunch of dozers, engine crews, trying to get a line connected, which will get our containment a lot more secure up to where the fire starts to enter Lake County. On the northern side of the fire is pushing up towards Lake County, up above Butts Canyon Road. And we still get some fire runs, 20 to 30 acres a day or so. But we have bulldozers and engine companies up there right now trying to get a handle on that. Working our way south from where the Cache Creek enters the Capay Valley, we've actually got black line from there. It's actually secured all the way from there to the community of Winters, and that area is in patrol. From Winters south to Vacaville, in the area along Pleasance Valley Road, there's still a lot of mop-up, heavy mop-up, a lot of structure damage. And we're right now trying to get that area secured so we can start to move people in during the repopulation phase. Thank you.
Thank you, Chief. Now I'd like to bring up our law enforcement spokesman, Chief Mark Essick. and underserved John Crawford.
Good morning. My name is Mark Essick. I'm the Sheriff of Sonoma County, and I'm here with my colleague, Undersheriff John Crawford from Napa County Sheriff's Office. We continue to monitor the fire with CAL FIRE resources and our partnership with CAL FIRE. We continue to be in your neighborhoods patrolling and protecting neighborhoods that have been evacuated. We want to remind people that evacuation zones are dangerous. We have numerous downed power lines, trees, and other obstacles and barriers in those evacuation zones. Additionally, we have fire resources in there. We have brought in considerable fire resources from CAL FIRE. They're doing incredible work, but we want those firefighters to be able to do their job effectively, and that is why we ask that you continue to stay out of evacuation zones so that we can do that work. As over the next few days, CAL FIRE begins their damage assessment. We will start to learn the extent of the damage in our counties. And this oftentimes is a time when we start to feel a sense of loss as a community, when we start to realize the after effects of the fire and the impact that's gonna happen to our communities for a long time as we try to get a grip on that and rebuild. And this is an emotional time for many people. This is a time when there's that sinking feeling really starts to set in about what the loss is. So we still encourage you to use those resources out there, the warm lines. You can call 211 for assistance if needed. But this is a time that we need to come together as a community and really help each other, checking on our neighbors and checking in with each other. So with that, I will turn over to the next speaker. Please be kind to each other and take care of each other, and we'll talk to you soon. Thank you.
Now I'd like to bring up our unit chief, Chief Jones.
Good morning. You received today's briefing. The incident is making good progress. The predicted weather that we were expecting overnight did not produce the lightning that we were expecting. This is great news. Unfortunately, that wasn't the case for the rest of the state. There was lightning, and which does spark new fires. I want to tell you that everyone on the line is extremely tired, but working so incredibly hard. I had an opportunity to see some folks yesterday out on the line, and I can't tell you how much joy it gives me to see them and the smiles on their face, because they are really very happy to do the work that they're doing. So that, I wanted to share that all with you. The size and complexity of this fire is not one that we've seen in times past. So I really want to let you know how much I appreciate your patience. As we've said to you for the many days that this fire has been, it's gonna take time to put this fire out. So I greatly appreciate everyone's patience. There are new fires that have happened throughout the state. We are number one for getting resources in as they become available from out of state, as well as other incidents that start demobbing their stuff. I will say that that is an adjustment that happens daily as new fires begin. You heard a little bit about the perspective of the broader size of these fires. So as reported, there was 1.4 million acres that have burned since August 15th. That is a little more than the state of Delaware. That's a very large size. CAL FIRE has 6 incident management teams that are staffed on a rotational basis year round. All 6 CAL FIRE incident management teams have been deployed statewide. In addition to that, our federal partners also have incident management teams that have been deployed throughout California. So everyone is working actively to put these fires out as quickly as we can. I want to remind everyone, it's August. Fire season lasts many months, and typically we've had fires in October. We have a few more months of fire season. So I'm asking everyone, as we've asked everyone here today, has asked you, is to be prepared. I'd like all of you, even though some of you listening in may not be in the fire line, I would like all of you to go to readyforwildfire.org. Have a plan, be prepared. Sign up for your alert and warning systems for your county, for your local areas. Be ready to evacuate and do so when asked to. Lastly, I just want to close and say thank you. Thank you to the first responders, our cooperators, everyone supporting our firefighters on the front line, and for those of you supporting the communities and those evacuees. Without you, we couldn't be here where we are today. So thank you.
Thank you, Chief. At this time, I'd like to bring up our incident commander, Chief Cavanaugh.
Yeah, good morning, and thank you for joining us again. These news briefings we're doing and these press conferences are very important to get information out, so I appreciate everybody that's joined us this morning to get the updated information. So as I've been doing the last few days or the last week, I'll give some of the statistics and some numbers and then get into an overall briefing. So right now for the LNU Lightning Complex, we're sitting at 350,030 acres as of this morning, 22% containment. We have right now down in the east zone, fire, the Hennessy Fire is sitting at roughly 293,602 acres with 26% containment. Our west zone over in Sonoma County, the Wallbridge Fire, is currently 54,600 acres or 68 acres and 5% contained. The Myers Fire, as Chief Waters talked about, we're feeling very good about the Myers Fire. It sat at 2,360 acres and 95% contained. So that is good progress, and that's what we're calling a win here on this large incident. So we're happy to see that the Myers Fire has been contained. As far as number of resources, we're starting to get a lot of resources in, which is good. We're sitting with 259 fire engines, 35 water tenders, 12 helicopters, 15 hand crews, 36 dozers, and a total of 1,857 personnel. With that, it's good to see the resources coming in and the operational plan and the organization. I'm feeling really good about where we're standing today moving forward. We have good cooperation with all the agencies and all the counties that we're in, and the plans are coming together. Unfortunately, yesterday in Solano County, there was another fatality fire victim that was discovered. Our condolences go out to the family and friends of that individual in Solano County. That makes a total of five individuals directly related to this incident that have perished. That's two now in Solano County. As Chief Jones was talking about, we had over the last yesterday and over the next few days, we had geared up for potential for new lightning, new starts, and what that may bring to our overall incidents when it comes to the weather. As of last night, we were pretty fortunate that we did not get hitting with new lightning. We didn't have the outflows from the wind. There was a red flag warning over the area for today, and that has actually been lifted. So that's good news. Continue to keep watching that weather, though, and that's why I ask everybody. So as we know, it can be very unpredictable at times. We have the best folks around trying to watch that for us and predict that weather, but things can change rapidly as it moves across the incident. With that, yesterday and the day before, we did have a pretty good smoke inversion that's been sitting over the incident. That limits some of our aircraft flying. This afternoon, there's going to be aircraft that are going to be flying. We've pretty much nailed, I've been talking about the last couple days, in that late afternoon, early afternoon area from around 2 o'clock to 2:30 to 3 o'clock, the fires get up and the fire behavior stands up on us a little bit. So there hasn't been a lot of active smoke columns that you see because of the inversions, but today you're going to see those smoke columns arise on us. We do have resources on the ground, and we have our aircraft resources that will be engaging heavily today as we move through. Damage assessment is a huge undertaking. We have teams that are out right now all over both sides of the east and the west zone, gathering and trying to validate correct information. One thing we want with damage assessment, it's a process that we have, and we want to make sure that we give the right information when we get the collection done and the data collected. We try to get those. Well, as soon as we get these numbers, we will get it out to the to the median out to the county. So we want to make sure we're validating those numbers all together. And once we start breaking those out per county, we'll start giving those numbers per county as we move forward. Repopulation has taken place, and we have repopulation is a priority that we've been talking about. We have numerous areas in the today that will be repopulated through Napa, Solano, and Sonoma counties, and even over in Yolo as well. So we're continuing to do that. One thing with that to the public, when you go back into your homes today, if you've been out of your homes, I ask that you just do a safety check of your residence and your property. Make sure everything is good and safe around your property. If there's, you know, if there's down debris, trees, if your property has been burned, just take a check of your property. People have been through there, but to make sure the roads are open, everything else. But I ask everybody just check your homes, check your property, make sure it's safe to re-enter your home. We're doing good, like I've been talking about. I think as we move forward, Vermont today, I think that, like I said, the plan that we have, feeling very confident about where we're moving. Weather is always a key factor when it comes into wildland firefighting. We have a very large incident on both the east and the west zone. It's taken a lot of resources, it's taken a lot of time, it's taken a lot of effort. One thing again though, I keep saying, is the cooperative effort and the cooperative communication that we have is the only way we get through this and mitigate the large incident that we have. So far it takes a while to get going, but so far we're happy. We're happy with the communications, we're happy with the cooperation that we have with all the agencies. There's a many agencies involved here, and it takes that cooperation. Thank you. Yeah, come on up.
Okay, as we've done each day, I'd like the IC to stay up close here, and we're going to turn over just a couple questions as they come up over to our team up here. So are there any questions today? All right. Well.